We got to know how to clean ourselves.
That's right.
That's what it is. We have to clean ourselves from the inside out. That's what the problem is. All right? Bring it up.
Ephesians chapter 5, verse 26.
Bring it out.
That he might sanctify and cleanse it with the washing of water by the word.
So that's true baptism. That's true right. Baptism is washing yourself by the word of God.
That's right.
You can throw water on yourself. You can put soap on yourself. But guess what? If you do not change from the inside, you will not change.
Right.
If you do not change your mindset, you will not change.
Right.
It has to be a biblical mindset. This is not our words. This is the word of the Most High God.
That's right.
This is about change. All right. It's more than just having the knowledge. You have to change from the inside. That's what our problem is. We can get the knowledge all day long, but if we are of this world, we will get destroyed by the Most High God. And that's why it says Deuteronomy 22:5, a woman can't retain what can't wear what retains into a man. Because God didn't ordain you to be that. God ordained you to be a princess according to the Bible.
That's right.
So of course these words are gonna hurt, but they're for your benefit. Because we don't want our people to get destroyed.
That's right.
Because this is why. This is why we preach it. Because Christ is going to destroy a lot of people that are not in order. That's what the problem is. We don't want our people to die. Read.
Zephaniah chapter 1 verse 8.
Read it. Oh.
And it shall come to pass.
Which means it will happen. This is a future prophecy. Read.
And the day of the Lord's sacrifice.
The day of the Lord's sacrifice, which means the day of destruction. America will be destroyed by nuclear fire. If you did not know, it is ordained by the Most High God. This is Babylon the Great. Spiritual Egypt, spiritual Babylon, according to Revelations 11 and 8. This is here. Read.
And it shall come to pass in the day of the Lord's sacrifice that I will punish the princes and the king's children and all such as are clothed with strange apparel.
So if the Lord see you in them pants, he sees a man in a dress or trying to be what trannies that they got nowadays, he's gonna destroy you.
Right.
Because God did not ordain you to be that man.
That's right.
Or that woman, he did not ordain you to be that woman. He didn't ordain those pants for you. He didn't ordain those pants for you. And I know we do a lot of Old Testament, but it's in the New Testament too. We teach the whole Bible, because when we talk about the laws, it's a problem. Read.
1 Timothy chapter 2, verse 9.
Read out.
In like manner also, the woman adorn themselves in modest apparel.
So you have to dress modestly in the eyes of God, which means covering up your body. That is modest in the eyes of God. God does not want his princess wearing tight pants, because you are going to attract sexuality.
Right.
You're not supposed to do that. A man's supposed to be after your mindset. Hispanic man, Hispanic woman, he's supposed to be after your mindset. He's not supposed to be about your behind. He's not supposed to be how big your chest are. But he's supposed to be after your mind. That's what a man's supposed to be after. All right?
With shamefacedness and sobriety.
Right. Shamefacedness, which means you're supposed to be shamed, not up in a man's face. And also, you have to be sober.
Right.
Because you have to teach the kids how to be sober. You have to teach the kids how to dress. Because that's the problem right there. That's destruction to our nations right there. Not teaching the kids how to live a holy life according to the Most High God. That's the problem right there. All right? God has a different way that he wants you to pray.
That's right.
He has a different way he wants you to pray. And a lot of our people don't know that, because they see it on TV. They see other people doing it.
Right.
Okay, because we are visual people. That's why. We are visual people. The same thing with these images right here. We're visual people. All right, read.
Verily I say unto you, they have their reward.
The Lord said you have your reward, because everybody says that you holy. So the Lord said you got your reward right there, because everybody thinks you are holy, blessed, and highly favored. Hallelujah. Read.
But thou, when thou prayest, enter into thy closet.
So soul. The Lord wants you to pray a certain way. So he says, when you pray, enter into your closet. That means a secret place.
That's right.
Where everybody's not looking at you. Read.
And when thou hast shut thy door, pray to thy Father, which is in secret.
Right, so pray to your Father, which is in secret. So you're not supposed to be praying on the streets. That is not of the Lord thy God. According to Matthew 6:5. Read.
And thy Father, which seeth in secret, shall reward thee openly.
So the Lord's going to reward you openly. What could be some of those rewards? Guess what? You could have had a wreck that day. But the Lord said, no, I'm not going to let him have that wreck. All right? You could have lost your job that day. The Lord said, oh, you know what? I'm not going to let him lose that job. I'm going to keep him alive. I'm going to preserve him to keep my commandments in the faith of Christ.
That's right.
That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to preserve my servant. I'm going to make sure nobody breaks into his house.
Right.
You know, but we have to do things God's way. That's what the problem is. We want to do things that the way that America taught us. And then push away the ways of the Most High God. And that's what brings us destruction.
Right.
All right, that's what brings us death. So we have to get things in order. Read.
But when ye pray, use not vain repetitions as the heathen do.
Right, so don't say the same thing over and over and over and over again, because the Lord heard you the first time. And we want the Lord to hear our prayers, right?
Right.
You want the Lord to hear your prayer, right?
Right.
Okay, John 9:31.
John 9:31.
We have to know how we want the Lord to hear our prayers. A lot of prayers, they're not going past the roof. They're not going 6 feet above us. They're evaporating in the air. The Lord's not hearing a lot of our prayers. But we want the Lord to hear our prayers. We really do. How you doing, brother? You all right? You know you're according to the Bible. It's vastly important, brother. You could be an Israelite. If your father's black, Hispanic, or Native American, you are an Israelite according to the Bible.
That's right.
Remember that thing. Remember that thing. You fit these curses, you're an Israelite. Read.
That's right. Yes.
John, right. chapter 9:31. Yeah. Now we know that God heareth not sinners.
So the Lord says he heareth not sinners. Okay, the Lord heareth not sinners. This is the Bible. Read.
But if any man be a worshiper of God.
So if any man be a worshiper of God. So how do you worship God? It's about to bring it out.
And doeth his will.
Doeth his will. Do you know the will of God, brother? If you don't know, it's okay. Don't be embarrassed. We're here to let you know. We're here to let you know. If you don't know, it's okay. Do you know?
To do as God says to do.
Okay, do as God says so. Right. But the scripture.
Oh,
we're practicing the Ten Commandments, okay. But the Lord says, if any man speak, let him speak the oracles of God. So we have to bring it out from the scriptures, okay?
Okay.
All right. So, Psalms. You get Psalms right quick. We're going to show them the will of God. Read.
Psalms, chapter 40:8.
Yeah.
I delight to do thy will, O my God. Yea, thy law is within my heart.
Thy law is within thy heart. Thy law is within thy heart. So you have to be keeping the laws, statutes, and commandments of the Most High God. Now we do the will, that's the will. But now we know that some of the law is done away with. And that's the big problem right there. Everybody says that the law is done away with. But how do you please God if the law is done away with? Because that's saying you just say, oh, no, I believe in the Lord. And now you don't have to do anything. Now you can be wicked. Now you can smoke. Now you can drink. Now you can sell dope on the streets. Nah, you have to do something.
Right.
It's like when you get a job, guess what? You don't get hired to do nothing.
Right.
You have to fit the prerequisites of the terms and conditions of that job.
Right.
If you don't do it, guess what? You're going to get fired. That's exactly what's going to happen.
Right.
So what do you think a lot of us are going to get? If we accept Jesus, but we don't do anything, we're going to get fired.
That's right.
We're going to get fired, according to the Bible. Christ does not play games. He wants us to do things his way. When the Lord gives a commandment, you do it.
That's right.
That's just what it is. Keep thy commandments and live. If you want to live, you will keep the commandments.
That's right.
You will not pray in the streets. You will do it in secret. as he commanded in the Bible. That's what you will do, because that is the child of God. The children of God keep the commandments of the Most High God. So we have to be children of God in his sense, all right? In his way. How y'all doing, y'all all right? Y'all know who y'all are according to the Bible? It's very important to know who you are according to the Bible, because you got to teach your son one day, brother. He gonna ask daddy, who am I? Who am I according to the Bible? You're an Israelite according to the Bible, brother. If you fit the curses of Deuteronomy 28, you're an Israelite. Remember that thing. Teach your son. Teach your son that he's the son of God, that he's a prince. He's a prince of the power.
Research Israelite.
It's very important. It's very important. Yes, 1 John 5 and 3.
1 John chapter 5, verse 3. For this is the love of God.
So we're going to teach you how to love, because a lot of people don't know how to love. They don't know how to love. It's more than a hug, it's more than a gift. Because a gift can destroy the heart. A gift can destroy yourself. Now you think the brother is okay with you. But he's there to destroy you. So he gives you a gift. He gives you a nice word. Nah. What you got? Cigarettes, 1 Corinthians 3 and 16. All right, 1 Corinthians 3 and 16. Yes, it's all good. It's all good, brother. We're just here to teach you who you are according to the Bible. And let our people know how to please God. That's it. That's it, bro. Free.
1 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 16.
Bring it up.
Know ye not that ye are the temple of God?
The Lord said, do you not know that you are the temple of God? You are God's vessel. All right? You are important. Did you know that? God said, and in that very thing, in that very genre, in that very scripture, he's letting you know how important you are. Your vessel is meant to please the Most High God. That is what it's meant to do. Read.
And that the Spirit of God dwelleth in you.
Dwells in you. The Spirit of God dwells in you. The Lord knew you from the womb. Did you know that? Jeremiah 1 and 5. He knew that you would be wearing that top, those bottoms, those shoes, smoking that cigarette on this day. He already knew that years before. Because he is the Alpha and Omega, the first and the last, the beginning and the end. So, he already knew where you were going to be at this day, brother. All right, read.
If any man defile the temple of God, him shall God destroy.
So him shall God destroy. So if you are defiling your temple with the cigarettes, because that's gonna give you cancer. That can give you lung cancer.
Right.
All right. You could be trying to run from a pit bull one day. Guess what? Now you ain't got the lung capacity to run away from him.
Right.
Not a dog gonna get you.
Bring it out.
You know? So you have to think about that thing. The things that destroy us. The things, the habits that we are around every other day that will pass down from generation to generation. The Lord wants us to break those habits. So we can have a clean vessel. So we can have a clean mind. So he can dwell in us. Read.
For the temple of God is holy, which temple ye are.
Right. So the Lord said, you are holy. So now you have to do the necessary things to remain holy. That's what it is. And that's these keep the commandments of the Most High God. That's what
right.
keeps you holy. The Lord already said that you are holy. He already said that you are a special vessel. So why would you need a cigarette to defile that special vessel? Why would you need that? All right, read.
Deuteronomy chapter 7, verse 6. For thou art an holy people unto the Lord thy God.
It is again, you are holy unto God. You're more than a Negro. All right, you're not a nigger. You're not a black man. You are king of this earth.
That's right.
Did you know that? You have the potential to be a ruler under Christ. Did you know that? You have the potential to be a ruler under Christ. Because somebody's going to have to rule this earth under Christ when he comes back. Did you know that? I know they don't teach that. They don't teach that in the church, in the so-called churches. Of course not. They'd be like, what? I'm supposed to do what? Exactly. That means that you have an important role. You are an important man. You have a way of life. Read.
The Lord thy God hath chosen thee to be a special people unto himself.
So God chose you. I didn't say you were special. God said that you were special.
That's right.
It's out the Bible right here. I didn't write this thing. Read.
Above.
Above.
All people that are upon the face of the earth.
Wow, you got to think about that. Wait a minute. He said that you, what's your name, brother?
Michael.
He said, Michael, all praises. Michael. All right. He said that you were above all people that were on the face, above the face of the earth. Which means that that's separation right there. Because I know they don't preach, you know, separation, but this separation is all up in these scriptures right here. All right. Even in this world, there's separation. There's a high class, there's a middle class, and there's a lower class. That's separation. But they said that we are all one. Are you kidding me? Then we all be high class. Then we all have mansions. Then we all be millionaires and all that stuff. But there, I know, but there would be an imbalance though. Because in each captivity that we've been in, there's been a high class, there's been a middle class, and there's been a lower class. All right? But right now we are in the lower class because of our wickedness. That's why. And these scriptures are trying to teach us how to become the high class.
That's right.
Forever.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.